What's up, West Side students? Hey, Psalms 156 said, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Do you have breath in your lungs tonight? Yeah. Let's worship Jesus. Come on.
Yeah. knowing there's a reason. All my dreams come alive, and life is for living. With you, I made my decision. Lift me up, fill my eyes with wonder. Forever young in your love, this freedom's untainted. With you, the moment is made. See the sun now bursting through the clouds, black and white turns to color all around. All is new, in the Savior I am found. This is living now.
decide what you say. Jehovah Nissi,
fight your battle.
Oh, yeah. Jehovah Nissi, fight your battle. Say it again. Say Jehovah Nissi.
Jehovah Nissi, fight your battle.
Yeah. Say Jehovah Jireh.
Jehovah Jireh meets your need.
Jehovah
Rapha, heal your body.
Jehovah Shalom,
be your peace.
Say Jehovah Nissi,
Jehovah Nissi, fight your battle.
Come on, clap your hands. Say Jehovah Jireh.
Jehovah Jireh meets your need.
Say Jehovah Rapha.
Jehovah Rapha, heal your body.
Say Jehovah Shalom.
Jehovah Shalom, be your peace. Jehovah Nissi, fight your battle.
Jehovah
Jireh meets your need.
Jehovah Rapha,
heal your body.
I said Jehovah Shalom.
Jehovah Shalom, be your peace.
So call the name.
Call the name. Call the name. Call the name.
But I'm glad to be here with you.
Sit down, be humble, sit down, be humble, sit down, be humble, sit down, be humble, sit down, sit down, be humble, sit down, sit down, be humble. Sit down, sit down, be humble. Sit down, be
What's up, Westside students? How are we? We're good. It is so Man, it's so cool hearing you guys sing back here and just really getting into it and everything. If we haven't had a chance to meet, my name is JJ, and I'm so glad that you've joined us for one night. We are in week two of a series entitled Names. We're looking at some names of God, and we're really looking at the characteristic behind the name. So here's the thing. If you have a Bible, I want to invite you to open it with me to Jeremiah chapter 30. I'm going to look at one verse tonight, verse 17. If you don't know how to get to Jeremiah, just go to the front of your Bible, find Jeremiah, find the page number, find the big 30, and you will find yourself there. So that's where we're going to be as you're finding your way. Let me just go ahead and kind of tell you a little bit about Jeremiah, because I think this is important for you to understand. Jeremiah was a really young guy when God called him to be a prophet of Israel. Most people actually would think that Jeremiah was around your age. And at first, he didn't want to go and do what God called him to do, but God made it very apparent, hey, I'm calling you to be a prophet. Now, a prophet is someone who receives a message from God, and they are called to go and share that message with the people of Israel. This is Old Testament, right? And sometimes they would share it to Israel and the world. So Jeremiah, he receives a message, and it's not really a good message. The message that he received was, hey, I'm about to send this country, this nation, Babylon, to come, and they are going to overtake Israel, and they're actually going to take Israel into captivity. And sure enough, what ends up happening is exactly what God tells them. Hey, Babylon comes, they take over Israel, and they actually take the Israelites into captivity. And what we're seeing here, so when we get to Jeremiah 30, it kind of gets us into this understanding that they're not living in freedom. They're actually living in captivity in this moment. But in the midst of this hardship, in the midst of the pain, God stretches out. And this is what he says to Jeremiah. For I will restore health to you, and your wounds I will heal, declares the Lord. Because they have called you an outcast, it is Zion for whom no one cares. Would you pray with me this evening? Father, I just pray in these next few moments that our hearts would be open to what you want to say. Not just open, but God, that they would be willing to receive anything that you want to say to us through your word. Father, I pray right now that you would just hide me behind your cross. Lord, that what they see is not me, what they hear is not me, but what they hear is you tonight. God, I pray more than anything else that the thing that they remember is Jesus after they walk out of this space and place. So we give you this next few moments. In your name we pray. Amen. Recently, I was scrolling through Instagram, and I was watching some reels, and I came across this reel that said something along the lines of, hey, this is girl math. So real quick, just show of hands, how many of you have heard about girl math? All right, if you haven't, don't worry about it. Girl math is pretty easy to understand. Girl math's like, if you go to Target and you buy a shirt and you try on that shirt and you like the shirt, so you buy it, and then you go home, and then when you get home, you're like, I don't really like the shirt and how it looks on me when I got home. So then you take it back to Target, you get your money back, you go and buy something else, which is cheaper. So it is what? Someone said it. No. It's actually you made money on the deal, right? Like, that's girl math. Girl math is going to Starbucks, right? Because we got to have our Starbucks or Dutch Bros, whatever. I don't even know what you drink, but Starbucks. And we got my card, because you have to pay with the card to get the rewards, correct? Yes, you have to get the rewards. And so you show up, you buy a drink, and then you realize, you're like, man, I loaded this card up a few months ago, and I didn't realize I had money to pay for my drink. And you pay for your drink, and it doesn't cost you anything, and that makes it free. That's girl math. Now, here's the thing. Did I do a good job explaining girl math? Okay, yes. I'm proud of myself. It took me, like, reading, like, thousands of articles to understand what girl math was. Because here's the thing about girl math. Girl math is not a real thing. I hate to burst some people's bubbles. It's not real. But there are some people out in the world right now that are extremely upset about these Instagram reels, because they're like, well, that's not real. And they're getting really hot and heavy. I read like four articles that, like, literally people are so upset about it because it's not supposed to be real. It's supposed to be fake, and it's supposed to be a joke. But you want to know something that isn't a joke, and it is actually something real. God math. Now, We've heard of girl math, but let me just ask you real quick. How many of you have heard of God math before? Anyone? God math is when you add God to the equation with whatever you're doing. And here's the thing about what happens when you add God to the equation. When you add God to the equation, anything is possible. When you add God to the equation, it is possible for you who are struggling with anxiety for anxiety to be over with. When you add God to the equation, it is possible for your parents who ended up having a divorce to see their marriage come back to life. It is possible when you add God to the equation for you to overcome the addiction that you keep running to over and over again. When you add God to the equation, it is possible for you to live the type of life that God wants you to live. And yes, when you add God to the equation, healing is possible. And the reason why healing is possible is because of what we just read in Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 17. What we read and what we talked about here is that God reveals something to us about himself. He is Jehovah Rapha, which simply means that the Lord is my healer. And what I love here in Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 17 is that God gives Jeremiah this promise. Now, the thing about when God gives someone a promise in the Old Testament, and even sometimes when God gives us a promise, is that he gives us a promise, and then there's this waiting period between when God gives us the promise to when he fulfills the promise. And so what we see throughout Scripture is that they waited for the moment for this prophecy to be fulfilled. So here's the question: how is it fulfilled? Well, I'm going to give you the most churchy answer I could give you in just a second, and you wouldn't be wrong if you said it. He fulfills this promise through Jesus. I love what the Apostle Paul tells us about Jesus in Colossians chapter 1, verse 15. He says this: he is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. What Paul is saying here is that if you want to know what God is like, go and look at Jesus. If you want to understand the character of God, go and read and study the life of Jesus, because you're going to understand about God. He is the image of the invisible God. If you want to know if God really is Jehovah Rapha, then go read about, go study Jehovah Rapha in flesh. Jesus is Jehovah Rapha in flesh. He is the one that fulfills this promise that he gave Jeremiah. And what I love is that if we kind of scan through the Gospels are the accounts of Jesus' life. There's four of them. There's Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. What we end up seeing is that Jesus, he heals people in one of two ways. The first way that Jesus heals people is he provides a physical healing. Provides physical healing. In Matthew chapter 4, Matthew gives us a little bit of a glimpse of what this looks like when he says, "And he went throughout all Galilee, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom, healing every disease and every affliction among the people. So his fame spread throughout all Syria, and they brought him all the sick, those afflicted with various diseases and pains, those oppressed by demons, those having seizures and paralytics, and he healed them." Jesus is our healer. And he heals people physically. And what we see throughout the gospel, again, all these accounts of his life, is that he heals people that can't see, who can't talk, who can't hear, who can't walk. He heals people who have fevers. He even brings a guy back to life. He unintentionally actually heals a lady one time, and she kind of walks up behind him and grabs the back of his shirt, and he heals her. One of the greatest diseases of Jesus' time, Jesus heals all sorts of diseases. He is Jehovah Rapha. And here's the thing that we believe about Jesus. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. What that simply means is this, is that we believe that if Jesus healed people physically back then, he can heal people physically right now. This is why, like, if you come to church and you have something that's really going wrong, or you have a family member that's going through something, we want to surround you, we want to pray for you, we want to lay hands on you. It's because we believe that our God is still a healer. However, have you ever had a moment where you pray to God and you asked him to heal someone and you believed that he could do it, but then he didn't answer your prayer the way that you thought that he was going to answer it? Or maybe he didn't answer it the way that you thought he should answer it? Like maybe for some of you, you've been dealing with some real things like anxiety or depression, or you may maybe even find yourself in a place of despair, and you've been asking God and you've been believing that he can heal you of that physical disease. And you've been praying and you've been crying out to him and saying, God, take this away. But instead of him taking it away, it just intensifies. Maybe for some of you, you've been praying for your mom and dad who are headed towards a divorce. And for whatever reason, you've been praying and then you got some, like a little bit of a hope, because all of a sudden it's like, oh man, like God's answering my prayers. They seem to be coming back together. And then it's like, nope, they're not anymore. Or maybe, just maybe, you had a family member who had something serious like cancer. And you prayed to God and you asked God to heal them. But instead of healing them, they passed away. Have you ever had a moment like that? Me too. Me too. And here's the thing. I wish right now that I could give you some verse. I wish that I could say something theologically to you right now that would answer all the questions that are in your mind and in your hearts. I wish that I had something to tell you that would eliminate some of the doubt that you have, but I just need to be real with you. I don't. In fact, I still have a lot of why questions myself. I still have sometimes doubts, because like when I look into the Bible and I see how Jesus did things, like I remember this one time my grandpa, I found out he had brain cancer, and I just began to pray. I began to believe that God was who he said he was and that he was gonna be able to heal him. And I prayed and I begged God to do it. And I remember reading one day about how Jesus, I mentioned this earlier, how Jesus like unintentionally like healed this lady that walked up behind him and touched this cloak, and then she was healed. And I just began to think, like, God, like if you could do that unintentionally, could you just do it intentionally right now? Could you just step in and actually say, I want you to do it right now? So listen, I understand the way that you're feeling. I understand the tension that you may be experiencing right now when you're like, oh, I've cried out to God, but for whatever reason, I've got all these why questions because he did not answer my prayer the way that I thought he was going to answer my prayer. And here's the thing, I don't even understand why. But can I tell you what I know about God? What I know about God is that he is a firm foundation. I know he's a firm foundation because that's the foundation I built my life upon. I know that my God is good. I know that my God even cares about me. I know that God is close to those who are brokenhearted. I know that God is working all things. Those times when we pray and he answers it, that's a thing. He's working for our good. Those times when we pray and we ask God to heal someone and he doesn't do it the way that we thought he did, or he doesn't answer our prayer, he's working that for our good and for his glory. And here's what I know. Our God is still Jehovah Rapha. And the reason why I know he is Jehovah Rapha is because the ultimate healing that God wants to provide for us isn't a physical healing, it's a spiritual one. It's a spiritual healing. And here's the beauty of that, that when someone has a relationship with Jesus and we pray a prayer like, God, heal them on this earth, do what only you can do. Step in and be Jehovah Rapha right now. When we pray that prayer, you know what the answer is? Yes. But the answer may not be yes here on earth. It may be yes in a better way. You see, the better way is not for us to survive just on this earth. The better way is to go be with Jesus. That's the hope and the promise that we have. This is why I love what Paul says in 1 Corinthians 15, verse 55. He says, "Oh death, where is your victory? Oh death, where is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus." See, for a follower of Jesus, when you pass on from this earth, it's not the end, it's just the beginning. So our God still is Jehovah Rapha. Why? Because his ultimate aim in coming to this earth was to heal us. And how does he heal us? There's a spiritual healing that he offers us. See, Jeremiah 30, verse 17. He says, "For I will restore health to you, and your wounds I will heal, declares the Lord." Can I go ahead and tell you what he's not talking about right here? He's not talking about something physical. He's talking about something spiritual. And how many of you have actually ever heard like of a cross reference before? Anyone like cross reference? You guys know what I'm talking about? Okay, some of you. Okay, if you don't know what a cross reference is, basically there's a verse, and if you see like a little like eye or something above it, like, and it has below and the bottom, you can find different verses. That's a cross reference. You should sometimes take a verse and go see how God fulfills the promises in there. That's called a cross reference. So I'm taking a verse and I'm going to go to the next verse, and it's going to tell me about this verse. Well, there's a cross reference I want to give you guys tonight. It's found in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24, my bad. This is what he says. "He himself bore our sins in his body on the tree, that we might die to sin and live to righteousness." I'm just going to pause, leave that up there for a second, because I think this is worth saying to some of us tonight. God did not die for you so that you could straddle the line. Okay, this is not the message tonight, but I feel like it's a message here in this verse. He did not die so you could keep one foot in the world and you keep one foot in the gospel. He didn't die for you so that you could continue to live one way on Wednesday and you can live another way the other days. He died so that you would stop living for the ways of this world and so that you would begin to live for righteousness, the right way of living. That's why he died. But then I love how he ends this into this verse. He says, "By what? His wounds, we are healed." So how does he heal us? By his wounds. You see, I don't think that we understand the fullness of what sin has done for us, done to us. Sin is like a cancer for the soul. Here's the problem with this type of cancer. It has taken over you completely. And there's not a pill that you can take. There's nothing that you can do. You can't be good enough. You can't try hard enough. You can't go to church enough. You can't pray enough to get the sin out of the way. That's bad news, right? But the good news is that Jesus, he died on the tree for you and I. And the Bible would actually say this: he became a curse for us so that we could receive his blessing. Jesus died, and it's by his wounds we are healed. Here's some good news today. When we think about Jesus, we can understand that Jesus still has scars. And when we think about his scars, we understand that it is possible for us to find healing from the spiritual disease called sin. But here's the question I really want us to wrestle with tonight. Do you want to be healed? I want you to think about this, and here's the reason why. John chapter 5, Jesus, he meets this guy, and the Bible describes him as someone who is blind, lame, and can't walk. And one day, Jesus, he comes to this man who's blind, he's lame, and he can't walk, and he asks him this same question: do you want to be healed? And here's the thing about this guy. He had been this way for 38 years. So of course the answer was, yes, Jesus, I want to be healed. But remember, he can't see. He doesn't know who's in front of him right there in that moment. So you know what he tells Jesus? He says, "Hey, I don't have anyone to take me to the pool. Now, what's significant about the pool is that the Israelites and people during this time, they believed that this pool had some healing powers. In other words, if I'm just really honest, I think the guy gives Jesus a bunch of excuses why he can't be healed. But he didn't realize that Jehovah Rapha was there. And so Jesus tells him this. He says, get up, pick up your mat, and walk. Simple phrase, get up, pick up your mat, and walk. And guess what happens? He got up, he picked up his mat, and he walked. Can I tell you something tonight, students? Jesus is in this place. And he is walking amongst us. And he's walking to some of you, and he's asking you the question that I've been asking you to think about. And it's simply the question, do you want to be healed? But can I just be really honest with some of you tonight? Some of you, you hear that question, and you're just like the blind man, and you're thinking of all the reasons why you can't. You're thinking, maybe I prayed and I asked God and it just won't ever happen. I've been this way for a very long time. Oh, if I give my life to Jesus tonight and I find a spiritual healing, then oh my, I don't know what people are gonna think about me. You're thinking of all these reasons why you can't be healed. But I want you to hear the words of Jesus tonight. These are not my words, they're his words. Get up, take up your mat and walk. Get up, pick up your excuses, and go after Jesus. Why? He is Jehovah Rapha. He is our healer. And so tonight, I want to just do something a little bit different. So here's how this is going to work. In a few moments, our band's going to play. And we're going to take some time for us to believe that he is Jehovah Rapha. So here's how this is gonna, we're gonna have some adult leaders and adults that are gonna be lined up in the back, okay? And if you're here, and maybe it's you, maybe it's someone you know, maybe you've been dealing with something that you're like, man, I want God to heal me from tonight. Or maybe my family member who's been going through this. We're gonna pray and we're gonna believe tonight. So what's gonna happen is these adults are gonna be lined up in the back. And I just want you to simply do in just a few moments after I pray, and I'll make sure you know that when that is, I just want you to lay down your excuses of the reasons why you don't think God can do it and just believe tonight that he can do it. And I want you to get up and I want you to take up your mat and I want you to walk and I want you to go ask someone to pray for you tonight. That's first one. Second one's this one. There's some of you here tonight, the greatest thing that's wrong with you is not that you're a horrible human being, it's that you're dead in your sin. It's the fact that sin has overtaken your life. And maybe you're just like, man, if I come to church or if I come to one night or if I come to this, then everything's gonna be okay and I'm gonna be good with God. No, that's not how you get right with God. How you get right with God is you get up, you take up your excuses and you come to Jesus. It's by his wounds that you find healing. So there's some of you tonight, you need to not just find a physical healing, you need to find spiritual healing. And so here's what I'm gonna ask you to do. I'm gonna ask you to get up. And me and some of our student ministry team, we're gonna be up front. And I'm gonna ask you to come to us and we're gonna help you out. And here's the other thing, if like you want an adult too, I promise you these adults are equipped enough to tell you and walk you through that process as well. Now, if you do not find yourself in one of those two places, here's what I am asking you not to do. I'm asking you not to be talking to each other. This is not a moment for us just to like, oh, let's talk to our neighbors and why this serious stuff. No, this is an opportunity for you to pray. Maybe it's not you, but maybe you have a friend that's gonna go back there and get prayed for. And maybe, just maybe, you need to begin to pray for them with them. So I'm gonna ask you not to talk. I'm gonna ask you to maybe just get into a mode of prayer, pray for them, pray for people that are gonna come up and find spiritual healing tonight. And if you don't find, let me just say this, if you don't find yourself in one of those two places tonight, that's okay. You know what your responsibility is after this service tonight? It's for you to go bring healing to our world. I'm tired of people telling me in the church, we don't go deep enough. No, you want to know what? You go deep, you got to go wide. And that's not happening here. You got to go outside these walls and you've got to go and you need to bring healing to the world. Our world needs healing. And we need to go do it. Oh, just tell me some Greek. No, you don't want to know Greek. It's boring. But there's people out there that need Jesus. And we need to take it seriously, Christians. So if you're not there, I'm just going to, it's okay. I just want you to pray, but then I'm challenging you. I'm challenging you, follower of Jesus, to go be healing to the world tomorrow. So I'm going to pray, and then if you want to get prayed for healing, for something, or you need someone else, go to someone. If you want to find some spiritual healing, you can come up, and I'll meet you right down here. So Jesus, we know your presence is in this place. God, we know that where you are, there's freedom. We know, God, that tonight there are some people here that they need to find spiritual healing. And I know that the enemy does not want them to come up front. God, I know that he wants them to delay. I know that he has all these excuses that are coming up in their minds. And so, God, I just pray that they would hear your words just to get up, take up their mat, and come to you tonight. For the one that's kind of like, oh, I don't know if I want someone to pray for me about this. Lord, I pray again for boldness to go and do that. So Jesus, we praise you. We thank you. So tonight, if you need prayer or if you want to find Jesus tonight, get up, take up your mat, and go walk. And if not, I want you to stay and pray over people.
Thank you. door, out to open door. Here it comes, so get ready for another one, cause another one is on the way. Miracle after miracle, open door after open door. Here it comes, so get ready for another one, cause another one is on the way. Open door, here it comes, so get ready for another one, cause another one is on the way. Miracle after miracle, open door after open door, here it comes, so get ready for another one, cause another one is on the way. Another one, another one, oh, another one is on the way.
ready for another one, cause another one is on its way. Miracle after miracle, open door after open door. Here it comes, so get ready for another one.
So we're so thankful that we can come to a place right now. If you're praying, that's okay. I'm gonna talk to the people that are sitting out. We're singing and we're declaring a song that we believe that if God did it, then he can do it again. And so we're gonna continue to open up to pray. I know we got some adults in the back that have some room to pray for you as well. But if you're sitting down, we wanna invite you to stand up and sing and declare this song with us. Please stay in your seats. Don't come up here because we got people being prayed for. Okay, cool. Thank you. I'm not gonna.
Break and again. So get ready for another one.
Come on, just voices singing it out. Sing miracles.
Cause miracles, miracles, open door after open door. Here it comes, so get ready for another one.
Cause another, with your hands lifted up high one last time.
Cause miracles after miracles, open door after open door. Here it comes, so get ready for another one. Cause another one is on the way.
Come on, give it up for Jesus. Yeah. Amen.
All right. Hey, isn't this amazing? Like when we can, we got a God that isn't distant from us, but we have a God that meets us where we're at. And here's the thing. Listen, we're so thankful for some of you for praying for the people that came up and prayed, the people that came and prayed for the back. Hey, listen, you may not know their names, but here's my challenge for us as a student ministry. It's for us to continue to pray for people. Continue to pray. You may not know their name, but maybe you saw something that they're wearing and God knows their name. So maybe this week, just take one person that you saw to lift that person up. And so it's been an amazing night. Have you guys had a good time? Yeah. Has it been good? It's good because God is good. And listen, we got someone that's still being prayed for, and I'm not trying to ruin this moment for a second. But listen, we believe that when we show up, that God's already here. And this is one night. One night, if you're kind of new to it, it's like it's all about us inviting maybe just one person that doesn't have a relationship with Jesus. And if you really, 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 really enjoy tonight, you're like, man, like I encountered Jesus tonight. Not only would I encourage you in a couple of weeks, we got spring break next week, to come back in a couple of weeks, but I'm going to challenge you to come to this thing called 1 week. Tonight was just a glimpse of what's going to happen June 17th through the 21st. I would love for nothing more to see this room completely filled up with people your age going after Jesus. And I promise you, we're going to go after Jesus. We have an amazing worship team that's coming. I have one of my really close, good friends coming all the way from Louisiana. And he likes to say, preach it, Jordy, to himself. And he's an awesome guy. And here's what I promise you. You're going to have a moment to encounter Jesus. And so tonight, listen, tonight we had this really cool, let's be hype, but this just needs to be here for us. Tonight, we're opening up registration at 9 p.m. Okay? 9 p.m. Registration's open. Okay, listen. Okay, so from 9 p.m. to 9 a.m., there's like a 12-hour window. We're giving it to you for the cheapest price that we can give it to you. Okay, thank you. But, hey, you're supposed to be doing this. I don't even know what I'm supposed to say. I'm just rambling, okay? It's all good. Okay, hey, it's gonna be $150. Hey, wait, before you leave tonight, we're gonna give you a card. However, I feel like giving away some 1 week registrations for free tonight. All right, so what's this one? Oh, so if you brought a friend tonight, go ahead and pull your ticket out. I got a golden ticket. No. Okay, sorry. Hey, can I get a drum roll, please? All right. 8, 1, 2, 2, 6, 8. Okay, did someone win? All right, let me read again. 8, 1, 2, 2, 6, 8. Okay, well, I guess Jesus came back and we're all here. Well, they didn't win. All right, here we go. Let's do another one. Here, I'm going to have Maddie choose. Is this the same one? All right, 8, 1, 2, 2, 2, 1. Did you win? Come on. Yeah. Woo. Hey, come. Come find Maddie. All right. Hey, if you're a guest with us tonight, we're going to give you a way to you as well. So let's, woo. It sounds like Ric Flair in here. Woo. They don't even know that. Sorry. Thanks, Mike. This is why I love you, Mike. You support me so well. Some of you are like, get out of here. All right. 8, 1, 2, 2, 7, 1. All right. Do I need to read it again?
Just the last two numbers. Oh.
Never mind. Okay, apparently I'm stupid. I'm just going to read the last two because apparently they're all the same other than that. Okay, 7-1. 7-1, 71, 71, come on! Hi. She's gonna help you. All right, so I actually feel like being crazy tonight and giving away two more. Is that good? Can we do that? No, I'm gonna do, I got in here. People that brought friends, let's go. I know, that's right. We ain't gonna have any money at the end of the year, but it's gonna be all good. 55. I'm giving you last opportunity, come on. All right, I'm going next. 62. Come on, dude. All right. 62. All right. Give it to her. All right. Hopefully, last one. Here we go. I got a golden ticket. Larry, come read this number for us.
8-1.
They're all the same except for the last two. That's what I got told.
Oh.
Yeah.
4. And the last one is 4.
44. Anybody? We got, wow. Okay. I'm not waiting today. Let's go 66. We got a winner. Thanks, dude. One more? You wanna do one more? All right, let's do one more song. Let's go, you guys, come on up.
Take it in vain.
I don't wanna take
everybody
it in vain.
diseases.
No one, no one, no one.
Fools can walk on the water.
No one, no one, no one.
Fools can answer by fire.
No one, no one, no one.
Fools can bring down the tallest of giants.
No one, no one, no one.
Fools can silence the roar of the lion.
No one, no one, no one.
Who else is worthy of worship?
No one, no one, no one.
Who else is worthy of worship?
No one, no one,
no one. No one,
no one, no one. No one, no one. No one, no one. Nobody like
party. Have fun. See you next week.
See y'all next week.
See you later.
Y'all dismissed. Go.
See you later.